Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Thank you to all those that are subscribed. That's amazing. I didn't expect such a massive uptake for such an amateur. It's really quite overwhelmed me. The messages that I've had, it's just been brilliant. So thank you for that. I appreciate that. And continue to like and subscribe. It's really appreciated. In the last couple of videos, what I've talked about is mainly how versatile the FreeBSD operating system is, and I shall continue in that vein. So today I'm just gonna go through how I have set up my own personal email server. So in this is probably going to be a two or three part series, I'm afraid, because it's quite an involved setup. But what it does give you is the ability to be able to control all of your spam filtering. It allows you to add multiple virtual hosts or domains into your email system using databases as a back end for that, for any passwords and domains and user accounts, all stored in MySQL. I just find this setup incredibly flexible. It allows me to store all of the spam configuration in the database as well. It will be based on PostFix, Maya, MailGuard, and Dovecot. It'll also have DKIM and OpenDMARC, and it'll all be on TLS. And at some point, with a spot of luck, I may even get to show you how to set up the TLS certificates as well. That will be using Let's Encrypt. So this is a very robust and secure system. Very scalable because it's using a database for the back end, and it just seems to run. The uptime, I know uptime is not important really, doesn't really tell you how good an operating system is, but the uptime that I've got on my server is just silly. The only ever reason that it gets rebooted is when I upgrade the OS with the FreeBSD install using source. I like to do it that way rather than use FreeBSD update. Just the way I like to do it. Obviously, there's no right or wrong answer to that. You want to do it nice and quickly. Use the FreeBSD update. There's no problem doing it that way. I like to run FreeBSD stable rather than FreeBSD release on my live environment. There's a reason for that. I like to have all the latest features, but with some stability. The way that FreeBSD sets out their release names is quite different to most operating systems. So you'll have the release, which is the release points that you can download and install. You'll have stable, which is kind of like the next step. So you'll get all the feature upgrades and anything that is new. And then they'll have one that's called current, which is bleeding edge. Literally every single change, that's what you get. Anyway, so with all that, let's dive straight into it. So we're going to move on to our terminal as always. So here we go. I'm already set up in my terminal. So the first thing that we want to do is make sure that we've got Portmaster installed. Portmaster is great for this kind of thing because what it allows you to do is just install a load of ports. And we're going to do this using ports rather than packages. So that means that all the software will be compiled as we're installing it, which there are a few advantages to. Mainly it's optimized for the system that it's running on. And that's one of the reasons we're going to do that. So make install clean minus capital C user ports management portmaster, and it'll ask you for some options. I'll zoom into this window when it's appropriate. So at the moment it's asking me for a few options. So we'll have mostly defaults. So now we're gonna just create a config file for the options that we wanna use for the various pieces of software. This part of the video is probably gonna be blowing. This part of the video is probably gonna be mainly installing. The next part will probably be install the setup and configuration. And then the final part probably be testing. That's the plan. If it changes, don't worry, I'll let you know. Okay, so let's go back to our command. So we will create the file. So this is a file in etc, and it is make.conf. So what we're going to do is just put a few options in here. Again, I like to use my Pico editor. I love Pico, just find it so much easier. So here we go. What we've got is we're going to install some antivirus on this as well. So it'll be ClamAV if anyone's used that. And we're going to change who it runs as and the group that it runs as and set some options for that. So we'll be doing it without X and with no GUI. Right. So there we go. So let's come out of there. Let's save that file. And we need to install a few other bits first. So the next part is a pair module. So let's install that. And we're going to add in the pair auth SASL. We need that. So from there, we're going to go to the next part, which is pair auth, and in this one we need pair DB and pair log. So let's make sure we've got those. Excellent. So the next one will be sysutils pair log. Hello. Interesting. That's pair log disappeared. No, there it is. And in that one, we need to make sure that we've got pair DB, of course. Now we're getting down to some of the better parts. So let's set up our configuration for Dovecot. So in this one, we need to make sure we've got MySQL and any other options that you may or may not want for these for this tutorial. I'm just going to choose that one, and then we're going to go for postfix. For this, we need to make sure that we've got MySQL. We also need BDB and TLS, which is quite normal these days. And I'm going to add in SASL for now. After that, we're going to do the same thing for postfix admin. We want to make sure that we've got MySQL. And we want to make sure that PGSQL is off. We don't need PostgreSQL. Spam Assassin. That's the spam filtering tool. So in this one, we want MySQL, DKIM, Razor, Relay Country, and SPF Query. That's all we need for this one. And now for my MailGuard, which brings it all together. And for this one, now, even though we're not going to be using Apache, we're going to tick it anyway. It will install it, but that's fine because what it does is actually install all of the other parts that we need. So we'll have Apache, we'll have Dovecot 2, we'll have MySQL Server, PFA, Postfix, and web host. That's what we want. If you want to tick some of these other things as well to install some other stuff, this is not a problem. You can add these in. These are just various archivers. I like to add them in now and then. Anyway, I end up installing them. So the next part would be to actually install the software. So we're going to tell Portmaster to install all of the stuff that we've just configured. And not confirm any of it. So if we've made an error, this is where we find out. So this may take some time. So what I'll do is I'll just skip ahead so that you don't need to wait for it. Okay, welcome back. So that's now finished installing. Took almost an hour, but yeah, it's installed now. So what we'll just do before we move on to the next part of the video, which probably will be another day, is just reset the password for the user vscan. So we'll set that to whatever we want. Just make sure you remember it. And for now, I believe we will leave it there. Next time, we will set up the MySQL, MySQL database, and move along from there. All right, I've been Gary. I hope you found this useful. I know it's only part one of the video, but there we go. If you find it useful, give it a thumbs up and a like, and share and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Thanks very much. Bye.